I got from the WWF.
No, that's for women. The cologne is for men.
Oh. Well, never mind that. I'll change. Don't worry.
I thought Deborah McMichael was sitting out here next to me.
Smelled good to me.
Tell you what, Kaientai's in a boat of trouble here.
Your opponents at a combined weight of 578 pounds, accompanied by the General Farouk and Bradshaw, the Acolytes.
I want you to take a look at Farouk and Bradshaw as we see that weird, wacky jackal. Bradshaw's meaner than he's ever been. Farouk has dropped 25 pounds. Look at those walk forward abs. These guys are fired up. They are ready to go. And I'm going to tell you something. You've got a tag team now with Farouk and Bradshaw. I don't know what Jackal's done to him, but it looks like we might find out.
We're joined now by the Jackal, and as we get set now for the Acolytes to take on Kaientai, the question is, and let's just cut to the chase here.
Right.
What are Acolytes?
Yeah, for the grammatically challenged out there, what are Acolytes?
That will be revealed in time to come. However, what they are is two prime athletes, quite clearly. Jim Cornette, have you ever seen two better pure athletes than these two men?
Well, no, I've said before many times, Bradshaw's as big and rough and as tough as you come, and Farouk, his background in athletics without question in wrestling and football, but I gotta wonder what kind of combination are they gonna make, Jackal? You couldn't have found two more disparate entities.
Two more aggressive individuals. Let's not talk trash. Let's just talk facts. Fact. These two men's athletic backgrounds have been far and away the best in the World Wrestling Federation for a long time. What they've lacked, if anything, is focus. They are now walking down the same path, and that means trouble for every other tag team in the World Wrestling Federation.
And I have to admit, we've talked about this in the weeks prior to this, Jim, is that Bradshaw and Farouk have never looked better. They've trimmed down. They're in tremendous shape. And right now, Bradshaw is dismantling Dick Togo. The question, though, Jackal, is what are these funky symbols there you see on Farouk's chest?
Funky symbols?
Well,
come on.
Wait,
you know what? We've all heard that term for stating the obvious. It's the economy, stupid. It's the athletics, stupid. This is not rocket science. These two men are the two best athletes going today, and it would take a moron to screw this up. Just let them do what they do. Don't worry about symbols.
What are the symbols? I mean, there's obviously a reason for them. We've never seen Farouk and Bradshaw wear them before.
You've never seen a lot of things out of the Acolytes that you're going to see.
Watch it. Togo into the stairs.
Hey, Jackal, I'm going to say this. I've never seen Farouk more motivated. I've never seen Bradshaw more motivated. We always knew they had the potential, and these are two big, mean son of a guns. But I've got to wonder again, can you keep two different individuals like this on the same page?
I don't need to keep them on the same page because they're on the same path philosophically. You know what? All they've done is unburden themselves of sympathy, of emotion, of guilt, and that means one thing. Their destiny is the WWF Tag Team titles.
Well, right now, Farouk's in a lot of trouble. Kaientai taking it to him, and here comes the big Texas.
Farouk looks like he's in a lot of trouble. Come on now.
Well, he was.
There's no trouble whatsoever.
Well, he was down, but he didn't stay down, and with Bradshaw's help, he got back up, and Bradshaw is just,
he's beating these guys like
they owe him money.
What we're looking at is three pieces of wretched refuse that are getting abused.
And the ref's calling for the bell here.
The winners of this bout, as a result of a disqualification, Kaientai!
Yeah, but the Acolytes aren't done. Kaientai in all sorts of trouble.
Whoa, there's Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi's in the ring.
Yamaguchi's going for a ride here. Look out!
There are bodies laying everywhere.
There's a midget in the ring.
As JR would say, it looks like a wreck on the interstate. These guys are stacked up like cordwood. And there goes Yamaguchi.
Look at this.
And here's the
this.
On the cake.
This isn't rocket science. This is just easy. It's what's going to happen from now on. Don't worry about DQs. Worry about the Acolytes.
Well, it may be easy for the Jackal, but I guarantee it's not going to be easy for anybody that gets in a ring with these two guys.
Jim, I'll tell you, that Jackal is whacked. He's nuts.
He's off, but these guys are definitely on, and they're going to be a force to be reckoned with.
Coming up next, Mankind gave it his all, and Team Corporate took it all away. Highlights of the match coming up.